Good evening.
God has given us one more day in our life. We are entering into the Holy Week. Today is Monday. We are really privileged to meet you through this video clipping. And definitely we will feel the presence of God on this day also. Our Bishop, Right Reverend Dr. D. Chandrasekharan, is consented to come and share the God's word to us in all these 3 days. So we'll have the Lenten devotion from him for Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday. On behalf of St. John's family, I take this opportunity to welcome him.
Welcome, Bishop.
Shall we pray? Surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases, that we accounted him stricken, struck down by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole, and by his bruise we are healed. Dearly Heavenly Father, thank you for this wonderful evening time you have given unto us. Thank you for helping us to feel your presence, even though we are in our houses. During this curfew time, you are allowing us to pray from our house. Thank you, O Lord. We consider this as the opportunity to enjoy the first century Christians' like experience of having house churches. In every house they used to pray, and God has blessed that, and the congregation was multiplied. We know that, O Lord. So our Christian witness may be a truthful one. We may all be a faithful one for you alone, O God, to bring all glory and honor. Almighty, please be with us and guide us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We'll sing from the church hymnal, hymn number 81. On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross. On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the cross, the old rugged cross, till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the cross, the old rugged cross, and exchange it someday for a crown. Oh, that old rugged cross, so despised by the world, has a wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear it to dark Calvary. So I'll cherish the cross, the old rugged cross, till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the cross, the old rugged cross, and exchange it someday for a crown. In that old rugged cross, stained with blood so divine. A wondrous beauty I see. For 'twas on that old cross Jesus suffered and died to pardon and sanctify me. So I'll cherish the cross rugged cross, till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the cross rugged cross, and exchange it someday for a crown. To that old rugged cross I will ever be true, its shame and reproach gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross, till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross, and exchange it someday for a crown.
The Bible lesson for this meditation is found in Gospel according to St. John, chapter 13, verses 36 to 38. Gospel according to St. John, chapter 13, verses 36 to 38. Simon Peter said unto him, Lord, where are you going? Jesus answered, Where I am going, you cannot follow me now, but you will follow afterwards. Peter said to him, Lord, why can I not follow you now? I will lay down my life for you. Jesus answered, Will you lay down your life for me? Very truly I tell you, before the cock crows, you will have denied me three times. Grace to you and peace from our Father. Good evening, friends. It's another wonderful opportunity to share the word of God with you all. Thanks be to God, due to whose grace I can have this privilege. And I want to thank my colleagues, Reverend Sudarshan and Reverend Inian Joshua, for giving me this memorable opportunity. There is an apocryphal book in the New Testament. Of course, it is not there in our Bible. Sometimes Roman Catholics do have this apocryphal book in their Bible. The apocryphal book is called as Acts of St. Peter. It goes like this. There was a great persecution in the Rome Empire in the first century. And Peter was fleeing for his life, and likely crucifixion at the hands of the Roman soldiers. As he was running for his life along the road outside the city, he confronts the risen Christ. Jesus is taking the cross and he is going towards Rome. And Peter is a bit confused and it looks very strange. So he is asking Jesus, Quodius Domini, Quadias Domini in Latin, which means, Lord, where are you going? Immediately Jesus replies, Romam vado etam crucifici, which means, I am going to Rome to be crucified again. Peter is completely broken and he gets courage and he goes back to Rome and continues to bear witness for the saving grace of God. Of course, eventually he became a martyr and he was crucified upside down. That's a very beautiful question Peter asked Jesus. Where are you going? Where are you going? Dear friends, for this evening meditation, I want to keep this as a theme for our meditation this evening. Where are you going? In Lenten season, particularly during the Holy Week, we ask Jesus, Lord, where are you going? Where are you going? And we know that he is going to Kolkata, he is going to the cross. Dear friends, for the evening meditation, I want to focus on two things, Kolkata and cross. Kolkata and cross. See, these two things are very, very familiar. We are very familiar with these two things. However, I want to have some kind of reflection to see what it really means for Jesus, the Kolkata and the cross. Towards Kolkata. Kolkata means the place of skull or skulls. It's a place symbolically known not for something good, but it is a place known for great suffering. A skull, Kolkata. When Jerome translated the Bible into Latin, the Vulgate, he translates Kolkata as Calvaria in Latin, which means Calvary in English. We say that is why we say that Jesus was crucified on Calvary, Calvary. And this place is not a place of honor or respect or any kind of splendor. It has nothing to do with religion or society. But the people, those who were found as criminals in the society or by the government or by the religion, they were taken to Kolkata and there they were executed. So it is the place of execution. But this is the place where God, very unlikely to reveal himself. The Kolkata is a place where you cannot expect, you cannot even imagine that God would reveal himself there in Kolkata. On the contrary, we always think God will reveal very powerfully in magnificent cathedrals, through bishops, through pastors, through clergy, through the learned ones, through the ritual. These are the kind of expectation that we have. But Jesus revealed himself, his divinity in Kolkata, which is very, very unexpected. We never even imagine that Kolkata has become the place of God's revelation. Dear friends, as we reflect upon his journey to Kolkata, we have to rethink our own understanding of God's revelation. Then comes the question, where is Kolkata? Where is Kolkata? Now, if you look at the Bible, it says Kolkata is bit maybe outside the city of Jerusalem. Jerusalem. But today, we do not know where to locate Kolkata today in Jerusalem, because it is a disputed disputed. The archaeology cannot tell for sure this is the place where Jesus was crucified, the Golgotha. However, our interest is not to learn much about the ancient Golgotha in Palestine, in Jerusalem, but rather the places that signify and resemble the ancient Golgotha today. But you put it in a nutshell, we want to really identify Golgotha of today in our own surrounding, in our own society, in our own context. Where is the Golgotha today? Dear friends, Golgotha today is the resemblance or the place which reflects the Golgotha of Jesus. The place of suffering, the place of punishment, the place of execution, not honor, nothing to do with religion, no splendor at all. And this is the Golgotha that we have to reflect in our society today. Look at the slums. The people dwell in slums. According to our country's statistics, at least we have 7 crore people live in the slums. The people live in slums, and the people who are marginalized, the victims of casteism, racism, and the women and people, those who are not accepted in the society, they are the marginalized, and they are the Golgotha today. But we never think that we have a responsibility to see the Golgotha of our days, to see how God revealed himself in these places, among these men and women, because we always think that we are saints, we have become holy people, and no longer we have anything to do with the slums and the people of Golgotha. Our spirituality made us to adopt a kind of separation from this kind of people. Dear friends, what is the direction for our discipleship today? Jesus still journeys towards Golgotha carrying his cross. So we are asking, Peter asked Jesus, "Where are you going? Master, where are you going?" And Jesus is going to Golgotha, a place where the vulnerable, the marginalized, they are punished for no reason. They were unjustly treated in the society. That is a place where the Golgotha is for the disciples. Now we have to examine ourselves. Where we are heading? Are we heading? Are we going in the same direction as the disciples? As the same direction as Jesus? Or it is rather in our search for glory, name, fame, position, power, status, security? Where are we going? It's a time, high time, that we as Christians, as disciples, rethink the direction our discipleship is taking. Dear friends, we have to stop for a while and we have to think our direction, where we are going. Are our lives leading to Christ and his will for us in this society? And second thing, what I want to focus is the cross. Again, when you reflect upon the cross of Jesus towards Golgotha, where in which he is crucified, we must be reminded well that in original context, cross has nothing to do with spirituality, our religiosity, our honor, our greatness. No glory can be attached with the cross. Rather, it was an emblem of shame, rejection, unholiness, and condemnation. This is the cross of the Roman Empire, during the Roman Empire. And the cross now became a symbol of domination, power. You know how it became a symbol of domination and oppression? See, it was during the time of Constantine, the Roman Emperor. In the year 313 AD, he saw the cross and he became a Christian. And through Edict of Milan, he declared that Christianity is a state religion, which means cross has become a symbol of power and glory. And from that day onwards, and following the colonization and the slavery and so on and so forth, we see the cross is taking a very different shape, a symbol of domination, symbol of authority. Now the question comes, what kind of cross that we are carrying now? Is it the cross which Jesus also carried? Is it the cross we carry as a disciples of the crucified one? Dear friends, the cross we carry as individual and as a church, a symbol of domination and oppression. Has it become a symbol of status, domination, or we identify with the crucified one? Even today, the crosses, what we carry, seek high position to the extent of dividing the church and the community and its institutions. Is it possible that our crosses have become glory hunting, status seeking cross, office seeking cross, divisive crosses? Dear friends, to put it in a nutshell, the essence of the cross is lost because we have taken the cross of our own style, not of the cross of Christ. We have lost the direction and we have changed, distorted the meaning of the cross of Christ. This is the time that we have to think of the cross as a means of suffering through which people can understand the love of God. Graham Staines, an Australian missionary working in Odisha among the tribals, serving among the lepers, he was killed, burnt alive in the year 1999, January 23rd, as Graham Staines with his two children, Philip and Timothy, as they were sleeping inside the vehicle, they were murdered by burning the vehicle. He suffered. He took up the cross of Christ, the cross which gave the life for many. The martyr, the death of Graham Staines made such a huge impact in the world at large, and particularly among the tribals of Odisha. And now they understand the power of cross, and they easily see the difference between the cross that we prefer and the cross that Graham Spain was carrying. So this is an occasion for us to reflect upon the cross that Jesus carried towards Kolkata. Friends, my friends, where are we heading as Christ disciples? What cross do we carry upon ourselves? The call is towards Golgotha with the rugged cross of Jesus on our shoulders, with a mission to put an end to all the crosses devised by evil forces. Lord, where are you going? Where are you going? Let us examine ourselves. Are we going to Golgotha, to the place where Jesus went, where the place where Jesus disclosed himself, the revelation of God among the unfortunate, marginalized, despised, not taken care of? Among them, Jesus disclosed his divinity. Let us go towards Golgotha of our days. May the triune God continue to empower us to follow the footsteps of Jesus Christ. We continue our journey towards Golgotha with the rugged cross, not with the beautified cross, rugged cross of suffering, which gives us life in its fullness. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Father, what is a domain? Where are you going? As Peter asked you, Lord, where are you going? We thank you for this Holy Monday, and we reflect upon thy journey towards Golgotha, and we want to know the direction in which we want to travel. Lord, where we are going? Help us, Lord, to follow you, follow your footpath. Help us, Lord, to examine ourselves. Are we going to the path of the discipleship which Jesus has shown to us? This is all the time that we reflect upon our own lives, O God. We thank you because you have revealed yourself, the place very, very unlikely for God to disclose his glory. It was only in Golgotha. Thank you for taking up the cross, a symbol of shame, a symbol of curse. We thank you, O God, because you have identified with yourself, expressed your solidarity with the marginalized and the cursed and the underprivileged people of this society. Heavenly Father, as we continue to reflect upon your suffering, inspire us, Lord, with your love, and guide us, and give us the direction which we should follow as disciples of Christ. The path that we have to choose, the mission that we have to take up. Be with us, O God. We sincerely thank you for the great sacrifice that your Son did on the cross. Thank you, O Lord, because you showed, you displayed your love, the supreme act of love on the cross of Calvary. We thank you and continue to bless us, O God, and inspire us. We give all honor and glory to your holy name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all now and forevermore. Amen.